Do you want to know about the squirrel that stole Sri Ram's heart? Well, if yes, then dive in. It was a really long time back. Sri Ram and the army of monkeys and bears now faced a huge challenge. They had to find a way to cross over the ocean to wage war on Sri Lanka and kill the demon king Ravan, so that they could get Sita Mata back. How do they cross from Rameshwaram and go to Sri Lanka from this side of the ocean to another side? This was the question in everyone's mind. On the advice of his friend Vibhishan, the younger brother of the demon king Ravan, Sri Ram prayed to the god of the ocean to give him way. Sri Ram did intense prayer for 3 days without food and water. At last, annoyed and upset that the god of the ocean hadn't even acknowledged him, he took up his Brahmastra. Just as he was about to let it go and dry up the whole ocean, the god of the ocean appeared with folded hands. He said, "O Lord, you have created all 5 elements. My nature is to be calm and unmoving. I am sorry for not coming sooner or acknowledging you. Even though you could have easily dried up the whole ocean, you chose to offer prayers to me. Trust me, that is all past. If you build a bridge on me, I promise to help you by holding it up to make sure you shall build one of the biggest bridge ever built in this world. Please spare me from this weapon." Sri Ram then asks the god of the ocean to tell him a place to shoot his Brahmastra. On his advice, Sri Ram shoots it on an island that causes lots of demons present there to die. The ocean god then says this, "The 2 monkeys in your army, Nal and Neel, are sons of Vishwakarma, the divine sculptor. Due to the curse of a sage, they manage to gain in childhood. Whatever they throw into the ocean will always float." Thus, it started. To cross over the huge ocean, spanning roughly about 400 yards, all the monkeys were building a huge bridge. Nal and Neel were throwing huge trees and boulders into the ocean, while others went collecting them. Hanumanji was writing the words Sri Ram on each of the boulders. A small squirrel was wondering what to do. He really wanted to help build the bridge and serve Bhagwan Ram. He wondered, "There are these huge monkeys and bears working to build the Ram Setu. What can I, a little squirrel, do?" The small squirrel then got an idea. He started doing something spectacular. He would run into the water, wet himself up, and then roll in the sand. This would cause sand particles to stick onto him. He would then go and shake himself on the bridge. One of the monkeys was going carrying a huge boulder. He nearly stepped on the little squirrel. "Hey, where do you think you're going?" he asked. "I want to help build this bridge," the squirrel replied. "You build the bridge?" The monkey burst out laughing. "Hey, listen to this. The squirrel is going to help build the bridge," he said to the other monkeys and bears, who also started laughing. They then told the squirrel to go back to his place. When he did not listen, one of the monkeys, now annoyed, caught the squirrel and kept him a long way back. The squirrel came back. He would jump into the water, wet himself up, roll in the sand, and then shake off the particles of sand on the bridge. The monkeys kept keeping him back. Then, annoyed, one of them picked him up by his tail and flung him far. He landed on Sri Ram's feet. Sri Ram was really sad about what happened. He picked up the squirrel lovingly. He scolded the mischief makers for doing that. He pointed to an area in the bridge. The monkeys and bears turned and saw that Sri Ram was pointing at the gaps between the boulders. "Look at the starting of the bridge." The monkeys and bears saw that the gaps were filled in with sand. "Could you do this? No matter how big you are, you couldn't do this. This little squirrel was filling the gaps with sand. This makes the bridge stronger and binds it together." The monkeys and bears then apologized to the squirrel, and they realized that they should never underestimate anyone. Sri Ram was really pleased with the squirrel's devotion. He had stolen Sri Ram's heart. Sri Ram lovingly stroked the squirrel. Three lines formed on the squirrel's back where Sri Ram had stroked it. Sri Ram thus proved that no act, big or small, is too small if done with pure love and devotion. Keeping this aside, think about this. Have you ever seen a squirrel? You probably have, many times. Maybe outdoors, in a camp, or a park. Did any of those squirrels ever have three lines on their back? If yes, you saw an Indian squirrel. If he didn't catch on yet, the incident mentioned above has caused only Indian squirrels to have three lines on their back. This is the thing that distinguishes them from other squirrels. Only Indian squirrels have these three lines on their back, and they are all devotees of Sri Ram. Who knew that even squirrels can have such a long and divine ancestral history? Jai Sri Ram.
Friends, we at BharatMark.com are involved in Sanatana Dharma Prachar and also exposing all anti-Hindu activities and fighting for our Desh and Dharma. Join hands with us by liking www.facebook.com/BharatMark page, also at Twitter at BharatMark, and YouTube just by subscribing, also clicking on that notification button to get an instant update as we post important updates and videos. You can also become the part of our WhatsApp club to get one dharmic message a day, which goes around the world, by sending us a message at +1 647 964 4790.